Welcome to another Wildflower Moment by the Florida Wildflower Foundation. Today we're talking about spotted bee balm, also known as dotted horsemint. Bee balm is known as perhaps the best Florida wildflower for attracting vast numbers of pollinators. From summer through fall, the showy blooms attract butterflies and a great variety of other insects not generally seen in any other season, including many native bee species. But hummingbirds also use it. It occurs south to Lee and Palm Beach counties in dry, sandy soils that are often disturbed sites, such as roadsides, but also in open pine flatwoods. It's moderately tolerant of salt spray, so it can be found near the Gulf of Mexico and along the Indian River Lagoon. It's a good cut flower for fresh or dry arrangements, and Native American tribes actually use the plant to treat a wide variety of ailments. A weak tea can be made from the leaves, so it's also edible. Monarda punctata is a perennial that dies back to the ground in winter in North Florida, but it can retain some foliage further south. It has a 2 to 4 foot spread and a height of about 3 feet. And it can grow taller with irrigation and fertilizer. Its bright green, lance-shaped leaves make attractive foliage that is scented like oregano or thyme. Because of its height and ability to spread easily by seed, it should be used towards the back of the landscape or in a place all its own. As a perennial, spotted bee balm will come back each year and can be divided to produce more plants in the spring when there's new growth. Seeds are commercially available, and you can purchase them at your nearest local native nursery or at floridawildflowers.com. Look for the almost black seeds, the size of poppy seeds, as a sign of maturity if you're growing this in your own landscape. And to collect, just cut and shake the stems into a container. Spotted bee balm is quite drought resistant, and in early summer, plants can be cut back to reduce the height and still produce blooms. Cutting back the bloom stalks near the end of flowering may also help lengthen the bloom period. Spent stems are beneficial to insects and birds, so you may want to leave them, but they can also be cut back to emergent growth if desired for tidiness. Full sun will bring out the best flowering, but partial shade also works. Spotted bee balm does best in sandy, well-drained soils, and some moisture may be tolerated, but when more nutrients are available, the plant is likely to grow taller and even fall over, requiring extra trimming or staking. In wet conditions, it can be susceptible to fungal attacks, so be aware of that. It's best suited for zones 8 to 10A, so most of Florida, which is great. For the best landscape performance, be cautious and purchase plants that are Florida native ecotypes, since the species grows throughout the eastern U.S. and into Canada. So we hope you are interested in planting some bee balm in your own landscape or patio containers, and welcome the native bees and other pollinators as you bring life to your landscape.